legal. There are many legal requirements that we have to follow, including minimum wage, equal opportunities, and discrimination acts. However, we do feel that we take into consideration all these acts and value our employees.
Over the past few years, people have become far more aware about climate change, and therefore we want to focus on being an environmentally friendly company. So we will reduce the wastage of our products and our packaging. We'll make sure that we use more environmentally friendly methods of not only gaining the resources, but also the manufacturing process. We're also going to give out bags for life to lower the plastic bag issue.
Our website design. Why is our website page presented like this? We chose this format for our website because we felt that the use of our logo, slogan, and a picture which stands out would help to entice a lot of customers to the business. The simplicity of the design makes it very easy for customers to understand how to find what they're looking for. Another reason for us designing the website to look like this is because complicated website pages don't look good on phones.
Vintage 90s is located on Bridal Smith Walk, which is just off of the city centre, and therefore will have slightly less footfall compared to places like the Victoria Centre or Old Market Square. This can result in us overall having less sales, but at the same time the operating costs will be slightly lower, which means that we will be able to reinvest our money elsewhere.
Due to our location, the cost of the building will be lower than if we were set up in Old Market Square. That allows for more reinvestment in other areas, possibly expansion in the medium to long term. The lower costs also mean that our total costs would be lower, which consequently means we can lower the prices to fit in an affordable price bracket. Another area that we need to make sure our rivals don't gain a competitive advantage over us in is the promotion aspect. We must find a way to be noticed for exploiting the new technology in social media. Many other clothes companies will likely be promoting their stock online. If we do not do this, we risk not reaching a large segment of the market. Furthermore, we will also showcase some of our clothes in the SU to make sure our target market cannot miss it, and because we know that our competitors are not promoting them.
It is important that our customer service is on a high level because our competitors are going to be also presenting that, so we need our customers to feel like they are welcome and desired by our company. This is because we want them to feel welcome and have a good experience while shopping with us. Establishing our brand loyalty will also help having a customer base. Our competition may deliberately set lower prices than our business to take some of our demand and increase their target market share, or some may use a premium pricing strategy to make it seem like they have a superior quality. Consequently, we will need to set a variety of different prices from low to high to prevent us from being too costly, or even being a cheap business where the quality is seen as low. We strive for affordable quality.
Next slide.
Okay, so for our business, we looked at Porter's Five Forces, which talks about the threat of new entry, the threat of substitutes, as well as the bargaining power of both suppliers and customers, whilst also taking into account the internal competition within the market. In terms of physical stores being set up, the risk is relatively low due to the setup costs, as well as brands already being set up on the high street. However, there will be a higher risk of new companies appearing online because the barriers to entry are very low. The substitutes, we will have a relatively high risk due to other brands that may offer similar styles at a possibly lower price. The bargaining power of these suppliers may be quite high due to the USP, meaning that there will be fewer suppliers which we can get our resources from, so they may ask for more favourable contracts for them, meaning they could go for 30-day contracts, and customers will have a large amount of power over us due to our USP, meaning that we may have to alter our price in order to accommodate them.
So this is a source analysis. So as you can see, we've got many advantages, one including the location. We've also, we aim to do better than anyone else's customer service. So as our store is easily accessible, the professional use of social media as well as our online website will help entice numerous customers. The individual prices per product provide a very varied range across the shop. So one of the factors that will help returning customers will be the 30-day return policy. So this will give the chance to get customers to be more loyal, because our friendly customer service will create a nice atmosphere for customers in the shop. The good prices, psychological prices, will increase sales, and finally the massive variation in products will draw in lots of different customers. The unique selling point of our vintage 90s is that 90s vintage is rapidly coming back into fashion. There's a massive gap in the market, and it's very niche. However, although it's a niche market due to its population largely being mainly students looking for products like this, there is a large target population.
The weaknesses. What we could improve. We could improve our range of products to help us expand the business, and we could also create some more deals which would bring more loyalty from our customers. Things we should avoid. We want to avoid setting premium prices to make sure that we don't lose our student market. We'll also make sure to remain an individual unique brand and ensure legitimacy of the clothing that we stock. Finally, we will continue to purchase products from within the UK to maintain a low carbon footprint. What factors would lose us sales? If our products become too expensive, we will lose our customers due to pricing out the students. Poor customer service will also reduce sales as people will not enter the stores regularly. Finally, a lack of range of products or lack of quality will also reduce sales.
So opportunities. What good opportunities can you spot? So we hope to be able to establish a niche market as well as provide jobs for students. Changes in technology and markets in both broad and narrow scale. So we will develop a social media for the company to gather more customers. Students who are always on social media, which provide an easy way to spread awareness for our company. So how do you plan to broadcast your company? As well as through social media, we hope to be given the opportunity to advertise the company and NTU's student union. To do this, we will hope to create an event which we can show the products and start off the business by quickly attracting numerous students.
The threats. What obstacles could we face? Potentially, it could be difficult to source the products at competitive prices, allowing us to turn a profit. In theory, it shouldn't be too difficult to get the attention of the target market. However, this could create difficulties. And finally, if competitors set a very low price, e.g. using competition pricing, it could create a problem for us with being able to make profit from the company. What are our competitors doing? Most competitors are solely online website, which allows our company to create quite a unique selling point due to us having our own store. Is changing technology threatening your position? No, we don't feel that it is. Through using social media, we're exploiting the advances in technology for our own benefit, and most certainly not being left behind through these technological advances. Do you have bad debt or cash flow problems? Potentially, we could encounter cash flow problems when first starting up the business due to the bulk required in the original purchasing of stock. However, in time, we should be able to cover these costs and compensate for any problems. Could any of your weaknesses seriously threaten your business? If competitors have better deals and cheaper prices, they could undercut our prices, which could seriously damage our company if we're unable to match these prices.
Originally, we decided to target the student population of Nottingham because of the two universities, which totals around 50,000 students. We then designed a short questionnaire for some of our nearby competitors. As shown by the chunk in orange, this shows the rough student population, and it shows that the main sales coming from these competitive stores in the area are from students, which backs up our original point to target them.
Our products will be available both in-store as well as online. This allows the students, if they are on-site, they can enter the store and physically try on some of the clothing, as well as get a feel for some of the items. Or if it's more convenient for them, they can order it online and we can send it to them.
For the price, we're going to use both psychological and penetration as our pricing strategies. These strategies should influence customers into spending their disposable income on the range of quality products that we will stock.
Our promotions will be mainly based towards students, and it will include a student discount of roughly 25 to 30%. We believe that this will encourage students to buy more volume and around the times of their student loans coming in. At the beginning of terms, we'll also be giving out other offers and promotions.
People. We will offer jobs to as many uni students as financially possible for our business, both within the shop as well as helping run the online aspect of the company.
The process. Regarding the shop, orders will simply be paid for and taken there and then by customers. In comparison, the online website will offer the option of collection from the store or 3 to 5 working days across the UK.
The environment of our store will include spacious changing rooms with sofas around and posters of fashion icons throughout the era. Hopefully this will create the correct environment for our target market and encourage them to spend with us.
Our products will be high quality items at good prices. Each individual item will be priced individually, creating a niche market with a large market due to there being lots of students in Nottingham looking for this type of fashion.
We'll run competitions throughout the year through our Instagram and other social media platforms. The prize will include vouchers to encourage people to come in. We also believe that clothing and music are linked, so we could provide events linked to some of the bars around the area to bring people together that have similar interests.
Thank you for listening. Are there any questions?